Welcome, everybody. This is very, very exciting. We're here in the jungles of Colombia, and the whole town is going to gather to receive the glory of the Lord. And I really wanted to start this class here from this atmosphere of glory. The Lord is really shaking the nations, and we really need to think and to ponder all of this that we are learning about iniquity. This class is so important because we're going to learn how our own iniquity or our righteousness has to do with the land, and that we are not just people walking around the world doing our own thing or trying to do the will of God, but everything we are affects the land. And as we are seeing all this devastation in Florida, now in Puerto Rico, Mexico City, in so many nations, it's like a real shaking. So I ask you to really pay attention and to really work your iniquities out of your spirits and really cleanse your life. So Father, let us all pray together. Father, let us call upon your name, and that your Holy Spirit may visit each and every one of our students, that this class will really change their lives, their understanding, and that the new people, a new generation, will start to rise up in the righteousness, in the lining up with God. Father, I pray for each and every one of them, that they will open their hearts and they will receive from you. And I release upon you the power and the glory and the spirit of prophecy, so you can really enter into the understanding of who you are and how you are affecting your own land. The Lord bless you, and we're going to watch this video that I have prepared for you, and we'll see you after that. The Lord bless you. Today we're going to see a very interesting subject that has to do with the curse of the land. It is very important that we understand this principle, because when we are talking about spiritual mapping, it is necessary that we understand that the land is a live entity. It's an entity that has received traumas. It's an entity that has a soul. It is an entity that has also a spirit. And it also has a government. We have been establishing before that whatever happens to one individual happens to the gathering together of individuals that conforms a city. And in the same way that a person can be emotionally affected or spiritually affected, the land also can be affected. As we analyze the history of our city, one very important part that we need to consider is ourselves. If we are going to do spiritual mapping, first of all, we need to do a spiritual mapping of our own lives. We are also land or earth, and we live in the land. And we also have many things that we have to start to map in our own lives. And this is because as we advance in the knowledge of these principles, that we are going to find people that are having problems and people that are having attacks. And this is not that we should not do spiritual warfare. It is God that is putting us in an alert so we can start revising ourselves to try to find out what is in our own lives. Because as we go on in the understanding of spiritual warfare, we are discovering a lot of things that pertain to the kingdom of darkness. And it is like if we have to do a judgment. And in a judgment, the lawyers come and bring up all the things that are against our enemies. But the enemy also can bring up the things that are against us. And this is why God is putting certain circumstances in the life of many students so they can see themselves in a mirror and see the things that they have to be strengthened in and the things that they need to be cleansed from, so they can understand why things are happening in their own lives. And this is because we are dust and we come from the earth. The Lord formed man from the dust of the earth. And we have seen this in previous studies in our classes of spiritual mapping.
and how this affects the land. And there are also generational sins. There are sins that we do that has to do with the gathering together of individuals that have committed things like genocides, like wars and things like this. So for us to be effective in what we are doing, we need to start searching ourselves. To understand that everything that we are also affects our territory. And in order to be effective in spiritual warfare, I need to understand how the earth was first cursed by me. Then this principle is very, very important. And the scripture says in Psalm 58, verse 1, "Do you indeed speak righteousness, you silent ones? Do you judge uprightly, you sons of men? No, in your heart you work wickedness. You wait out the violence of your hands in the earth." So we're going to see how, as we came from a fallen nature, we have affected our lands. And if the earth is cursing us, we are not going to have any authority to do spiritual warfare in the future. So this class is very important because it has to do with your own spiritual mapping. So we're going to see in this study, and we're going to consider as well in this study, everything that we speak out, everything that we are judging. And when we talk about spiritual warfare, we are talking about justice. We are talking about bringing the righteousness of God over the land. Now, all war is a judgment, and we are going to bring to judgment the works of the devil. Now, we are going also to exercise the power of the cross of Calvary, but we cannot forget that we also have an accuser that has come against us. And we have things that we have not brought to the cross of Calvary, rather by ignorance, rather because we didn't know, rather because we don't know how to search in our hearts. And there's many people that do not know how to research themselves. So many times we do confessions in a general way. Oh Lord, forgive me of all my sins, forgive me from all my iniquities. And the spiritual world, and above all the devil, is a great legalist. So we need to analyze what comes out from our mouths and the works of our hands, and analyze the alliances that we have with the spiritual world to be able to cut off all these things. And that way we will be advancing in our classes with an understanding that from this moment on is going to be increased in intensity and in levels that are much more higher. And we need all our students to be prepared and to understand that as sons of God, we have to be filled with the presence of God, to be altars for Him, the living God, to be able to release the presence of God, the glory of God, and the redemption that God gave us upon the land. So, let's watch the video.